the platform. Please tell us about your experience.
I've actually started my career with a short film called Shore, which Anurag had produced it way back in time. And that really changed a lot of things for me, because back then, Anurag, the producer of the film, used to think that, you know, I'm here to just while away my time, I'm not serious about my career, I'm not serious about filmmaking. When he saw the first film, Shore, he got really excited and he said, you have to make more films, you have to stay, you can't go anywhere. So I have special attachment to short films because it gives the democratic freedom for you to choose and pick and do what you, exactly what you want. And also it gives a certain kind of discipline because of the shortage of time. I think the real kind of creativity comes in only then, when you have really paucity of time and also the freedom to make what you want to do, which is why I really love making shorts. And since, I mean, I will always, sadly, you know, a lot of tweets came to me about talking about, sir, ye sab to theek hai, feature film agli wali kab bana rahe ho? And I don't know why this notion is there in India that, you know, if you're making feature films, you cannot make short films. I think abroad, everybody makes short films. And I've always wanted to make this. And large short films as a platform, I'm so happy to be associated with them because they are by far the widest, they have the widest reach and maximum number of people are watching their films, and they've kind of held this pedigree and this reputation that they are the biggest short film content providers. And when Juice happened about, it was, I've seen what you've seen right now in my family as I grew up, and I've seen it in many families. But what I recently noticed is that the same phenomena of, you know, the men sitting and enjoying their entitlement in the living room while the women are suffering through in their kitchens has passed on to my generation, my cousins and, you know, their families and stuff. And I thought this is not right, because as I grew up and I learned about many things, now I realize that it is so wrong. And it is not just a, you know, small town phenomena. It is about, you see this everywhere. So I was very passionate about it, and I actually saw this happening. So I had a big argument with my cousins and my sisters about how this is wrong. So I slowly started that small little change in my own family. And then I thought, why not make a film? So that's when Lalit came on board. So Lalit heard the story and he instantly wanted to do, and he had this amazing connect with the story himself. So I thought that I couldn't have found a better partner who almost, when I even read the script, that he said somewhere, I think I'm somewhere, have been party to it. That's what is this film is about, to be honestly admitting that we all have some time or the other been unconsciously patriarchal, unconsciously being misogynist. And that is what this film is about, that those barriers that we've created, and which is why we made this film.
Thank you. Shefali ma'am, what was your motivation to step on board for Juice? And also please tell us about your association with Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Short Films.
My motivation was Neeraj Gevan. I wanted to work with him, and when I heard the script, I thought it was absolutely liberating and fantastic. And the part is great, but it's not just about Manju. It's about so many women, from my generation to my mother's generation to, it just gets carried forward. So, that was my reason. I mean, there was actually no reason why I would have said no. It's just fantastic. It's a great film. It's a brilliant director I respect and admire tremendously. And I'm glad we're associated with the large short films, because they do, like Neeraj said, have a very, very large platform and exposure. So, yeah, it's great.
Lalit sir, please tell us about your experience. How was it working on the film Juice?
So the I would say that experience with these talented people has always been, you know, you get into a dream and then you get up and then Neeraj is there and then narrating a film. So it's the biggest thing can happen to a producer like us. The objective, I would say, was basically we always wanted to get into the short films. This is our foray into short films, and so that's what
I just want to add something here. There is one person responsible for all of us, three of us sitting here making this film. There's Chaitanya, who's sitting in the corner from Tulsi. So he's really made this possible for us.
So Shefali ma'am, I would also like to ask you, like, you know, you've been in the industry for so long, and now that short films are getting so popular, do you see a trend shift? Do you see short films will eventually take over the feature films? What are your thoughts on this?
I'm not sure if they'll take over the feature films, but they'll be at par with the feature films, to say so. They already are, I think. You know, they're accessible. Everyone's on their phones right now, and it's absolutely accessible. Also, I think short films are more difficult to make and more challenging to make than feature films. And like Neeraj said, not only can you express your entire creativity, but then there are time restraints and there are budgetary restraints, and you exploit whatever you want to creatively. So it's very fulfilling. It's extremely enriching and fulfilling. I mean, that's what I feel.
Neeraj sir, I would also like to ask you, as a director, how different is it to work on a short film compared to a feature film? Like, what are the kind of challenges, or what's your experience as a whole?
I would say more than challenges, actually, it is very liberating, because in short films, you exactly make what you want to make. In feature films, at least there is some bit of a pressure that, you know, we are all responsible filmmakers, so we all think about, you know, because there's a big budget in a film and you want it to make money, or at least break even. You don't want the losses to have to the producer. But short film gives you that genuine democratic forum where you can explore the themes that you want to make. And if you get producers like him who will back you all the way. So that is like a bonus for all of us. And in short films, what happens is, like I said, the themes that you can pick up, which is truly you, which you really want to make, because there was no pressure for me to actually make this film. But something came out of me strongly and I wanted to make this film, which is why we made this film. And in that, in a succinct period of, let's say, 13 minutes or so of this film, you have to say so many things. So that is a real challenge for me. And it really keeps you on toes. You know, brevity is something that, you know, really doesn't come easy for me. So short film as a medium really gives me that chance to actually make those things. And also it's faster in time, and also you can reach out to a lot of people. And yes, I to be honest with you, I actually don't see much of a difference between a feature and a short. It's just the duration and this thing. But thematically, I think, yes, we are all trying to say something new, something, you know, different, and something which is very totally personal.
And how impactful do you think short films are?
See, there's no yardstick. I mean, you can make a very very foolish short film, or you can make a very foolish feature film, but a good short film. I generally don't term, I mean, there's no yardstick to compare that, you know, they're more impactful or whatever. It is all respective to the medium also, because theater, online, how do you watch it, where do you watch it, if you're watching in a train, inside your mobile phone, download a, you know, fake print, how is it? So it depends on a lot of factors, I would say.
Okay, the floor is now open for discussion. Does anyone have any questions?
Hi, Neeraj, Justin here. Neeraj, at what point did you think that perhaps Shefali Shah could be approached to play this role? Or was it from day one, or you realized after scripting?
No, the script was written beforehand. And I did want somebody who is, you know, someone who will probably not give away that in the end this is going to happen. But somewhere I felt that, you know, a lot of my sisters, a lot of my friends and all, they really look up to Shefali, and they've had this thing since the time of Satya, I think, because they really look up to her as this really strong woman, and they say that, you know, she's so nice, you know, why don't you work with her, why don't you work with her? Then I thought that, you know, if she is commanding that kind of power to influence a certain large population and a lot of women to come to understand what we're trying to say through this film, if it gives that championing through her persona, through her personality, so I thought, why not? And she's a phenomenal actress. So I think that was like a, you know, I couldn't have asked for a better thing.
Also, Neeraj, I think it was last year when you had said that you are under tremendous pressure to make your next feature film. In the past 1 year, you've made several shorts, you've directed advertisements. When do we see that happening? Is there still pressure to make the next big one?
See, the pressure is always there, and I'm thankfully I'm making these shorts and advertisements to kind of get away. But like, you know, I want to constantly make something. So I feel like this is almost like a second film for me, because, yeah, I mean, it's everything there. It's just the duration is like 13, 14 minutes. But yeah, I've tried to say a lot many things through this film that I wanted to say in my feature films as well.
Also, Shivali ma'am, there's a wonderful scene in the short where I think the women are discussing how after marriage or after giving birth, you have to quit your job and things like that. Something like that we also see here happening in the industry when a particular actor gets married. The roles start drying up. Do you think it's really sad that something like this happens?
It's not just after they get married. It's after a certain age that suddenly women, they don't know what to do with actresses. So either you're an 18, 20, 22-year-old heroine of a film, or you're cut to directly the mother of a 30-year-old. They don't know what to do with actors in between, which is really sad. So I don't think it has to do with marriage or, role-playing as such. But I just think it's a much bigger and wider discrepancy, which is really sad, disappointing actually.
But then are there better roles written for women today as compared
to perhaps... There are fantastic roles. There are some fantastic roles. And I have to say, I have to admit that yes, it is changing. I mean, there are roles for Vidya Balan, or there is, Lipstick Under My Burqa, or there is Pink. So there are these films which are women-oriented films. And when you see Lipstick Under My Burqa, or you see... they're all they're not exactly women in their 20s, but
women are actually experimenting a lot more than the male stars these days. You can clearly see the difference between what all the top three female stars are doing, such different kind of roles, but the male stars always have to cater to that one massy tag of being this superstar, you know. So that's the difference I've seen in so far in all these. So yes, it's a question to her, but I just wanted to.
Hi, Shefali, this is Priyanka. We have normalized misogyny and patriarchy so much that we don't realize that we are part of it as women, as men. At what point in your life did you realize that, these are the things we need to get away with? We need to get done with, personally.
I've seen my mother do this all the time. And I think what happens is because you've seen it, it's imbibed in you. And it comes naturally to you to serve before you sit to eat. I realized that this needed to change. If I had daughters, I would have raised them differently. But I have two sons. And I know that this change can come from the way you raise your children. So... they don't get treated in any special way because they're boys. They have to pick up the plate. They just have to do it. And I really genuinely feel that the way we raise our sons or the way we raise our children is going to impact the society that's going to be formed. Because we are still influenced by the past generation. But our children are, it's strange because our generation is somebody who's still responsible for our parents as well as our kids. Our kids are going to move on and just do their own thing. But if they're raised right, then I think there is a big hope of change.
Also, Neeraj, wanted to ask, you spoke about democratic freedom of, in creativity. What do you have to say about, the controversy surrounding Padmavati, or in Iffy, how two films were taken away from the festival by the government? And, the protest and the death threats to a leading actor or director. Where does it leave artists to, make films and cinema?
I know this is about Jews, but kind of digressing, but I still want to make my point about... I actually was genuinely appalled. I was ashamed myself as a citizen. Because to see that a man, a fringe from... Yeah, we call it fringe, but it's the new mainstream. This goon can come on national television and announce that he's going to put up 5 crores for her Deepika's head or her nose, and then it is up to 10 crores to burn her alive.
And that's by a BJP leader in Haryana.
On national television. And the television channel is allowing that, and we are seeing it, and nothing has happened about them. That is a crying shame about the status that we are in. So I think I really feel that, this is a time where we all are being somewhere feeling the pressure of it. Sexy Durga and nude not being allowed in Iffy. These are the times that we all want to question, and we want to bring in some kind of thing. But something that deeply hurt me was that the biggest star, the biggest female star in our country, is is she's threatened like this on national television, and there are no charges, there are no arrests being done so far, and it is done in fact to save the honor of a fictitious woman. How ironic is this? How ironic these times are? I mean, it is really shocking to say this.
Shefali, your comments on the same?
It's shameful. I mean, it's really shameful that, and exactly like Neeraj said, I mean, you go on to national television and they allow you to go on to national television and say something like this. It's appalling. And it again boils down to the same thing, because, you know, you're talking, when we talk about feminism, it's that term has been used very wrongly of late. But here we're talking about equalism. It's just about being equal, whether it's caste, creed, gender, sex, color, whatever it is. And what about the democracy? I mean, there is a certain creative liberty a director or an actor is allowed to take, but obviously that doesn't seem to be visible anymore. It's really, really shameful.
Actually, even the film somewhere also kind of hinted at the intersectionality that she's talking about. If you see, there's a scene where the house help, she's offered tea, and the guest in the house, you know, in fact, if you see, her character is actually not, somewhere there are flaws in her character also, because if you see, she is used to giving her house help, you know, tea in a normal cup, okay, but when the guests arrive, and the guests say that, you know, how can you serve chai in that cup to her, because for house help and stuff, they have a separate cup. So she hands over a very dirty cup to her, and she agrees to it. She doesn't fight back, and that is what I think gives her a trigger to, you know, because she realizes that she's been complicit into this, and that's the whole thought, you know, because like she said, feminism is not just there's this not gendered feminism is not the only thing. There are many layers to it. The intersectionality actually cuts across caste, creed, class, religion, all of these. I mean, that many people actually have shown. Some of them interpreted as class, some of them interpreted as caste. But to each his own, and you know, the difference is there. I mean, women are themselves one of the biggest perpetrators of patriarchy. If women don't unite, they, you know, I don't think anything is going to happen.
Neeraj ji and Shefali ji, kya aisa nahi ho sakta ki hamari Indian society mein, here, hamari Indian society mein, ya fir hum keh sake ki husband, wife, sabhi saath mein baith ke juice ka enjoy kar sake? मतलब जिस तरह से आपने फिल्म में दिखाया
नहीं देखिए ये बात किस चीज की हो रही है कि पुरुष प्रधानता की हो रही है जैसे हमारे जैसे हम बड़े हुए हैं तो वैसा एक दायरा बना दिया है कि ये कमरा यहाँ मर्द बैठेंगे यहाँ ये लोग पिएंगे ये लोग जो भी बात कर रहे हैं बड़ी बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है ठीक है और बचपन से हमें बताया गया कि देखो अंकल लोग बात कर रहे हैं ठीक है पापा लोग बात कर रहे हैं वहाँ जाओ चाहे वो दुनिया की सबसे फालतू चीज बात कर रहे हो और वो हवा बैठ के जोक्स निकालने के अरे वो वाली आंटी वो आजकल तो बड़ा मतलब सूट पहन के निकल रही है वो सब ऐसे बातें होती रहती हैं बट लोगों को लगता है कि अरे वो तो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बातें कर रहे हैं तो ये एक है जो मेल इंटाइटलमेंट बोलते हैं जो हम सब मर्दों को है और हमें उस चीज़ का एक एहसास होना चाहिए कि नहीं हम लोग हैं हमारे पास वो प्रिविलेज है और उस प्रिविलेज को हम मतलब एक जुडिशियसली यूज़ करना चाहिए कि नहीं भाई अगर ऐसा है तो ये नहीं कि हम ये नहीं बोल रहे हैं कि भाई औरतें भी वहाँ पर चलाओ क्यों उनको क्यों नहीं हक क्योंकि क्या लिविंग रूम सिर्फ मर्दों का है क्या इंटेलेक्चुअल स्पेस जैसे बहुत बार मैं देखता हूँ कि न्यूज़ व्यूज की बातें रहती थी तो बीवी आगे तो अरे न्यूज़ व्यूज तुम्हारे क्या पल्ले पड़ेगा पॉलिटिक्स तुम्हारे क्या पल्ले पड़ेगा छोड़ो सो ये हम लोगों ने ये एक